Hello and welcome to Your World This Week, the weekly roundup for all the top news stories of the week. The top news stories this week are:
recorded 16,577 new COVID-19 cases and 120 deaths in the last 24 hours. With this, the country's total virus caseload rose to more than 1.10 crore, while the death toll surged to 1.5 lakh. India has administered coronavirus vaccines to over 1.3 crore people already, and in the next phase of the nationwide vaccination drive, those who want to get vaccine will have the option of either registering online or walking into a designated inoculation center. Self-registration for beneficiaries above the age of 60 and those who are above the age of 45 years and have associated comorbidities will begin on March 1. The next phase of vaccination is aimed at protecting 27 crore Indians. Meanwhile, as a part of Vaccine Maitri initiative, India has provided around 361.94 lakh doses of COVID vaccine to countries around the world. Of these, 67.5 lakh doses have been supplied as grant assistance, while 294.4 lakh doses were provided on commercial basis. On the domestic front, in the wake of fresh spike in COVID-19 cases, Maharashtra government has imposed a fresh set of restrictions in different districts to mitigate the spread of the virus. In the view of rising number of cases, a negative RT-PCR report is required if you're traveling to Maharashtra from Gujarat, Delhi NCR, Goa, Rajasthan and Kerala. This is applicable to all travelers, irrespective of whether they are traveling by flight, rail or by road. Different states have also made RT-PCR negative report mandatory for granting entry to passengers arriving from 5 high caseload states including Maharashtra, Kerala, Punjab, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. 1,30,000 seat arena at Motera in the Prime Minister's home state of Gujarat, which was inaugurated on Wednesday by President Ramnath Kovind, will be now known as Narendra Modi Cricket Stadium and will be a part of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Sports Enclave, known earlier as Sardar Patel Stadium or Motera Stadium. Before the massive redevelopment, the new name was revealed only when President Kovind opened a digital plaque which said that the Narendra Modi Stadium has been inaugurated. This is the first such public structure to be named after Prime Minister Modi in the country, with the Gujarat government confirming later that it would be called Narendra Modi Cricket Stadium. In his address, the president credited PM Modi with conceptualizing the new stadium when he was the Chief Minister of Gujarat and heading the Gujarat Cricket Association. India is called the powerhouse or hub of cricket, so it is apt that the world's biggest stadium is in our country, President said. On the diplomacy front, India and Pakistan released a joint statement on Thursday saying that they have held discussions regarding establishing a mechanism for hotline contact among both the nations. Both sides also agreed to a ceasefire along the line of control starting from February 25. Director Generals of Military Operations of India and Pakistan also reviewed the current situation across the LOC and other sectors in a free, frank and cordial atmosphere. In the interest of achieving mutually beneficial and sustainable peace along the borders, the two DGMOs agreed to address each other's core issues and concerns which have propensity to disturb peace and lead to violence. The statement issued in Delhi and Islamabad read this, adding that they would use existing mechanism of hotlines and flag meetings to resolve the misunderstandings. Apart from this, India has reiterated that its position on key issues with Pakistan remains unchanged. India has also stated that position that talks with Pakistan cannot take place until it stops supporting terrorists and infiltration. Regulate digital content and streaming platforms. The center has finalized a set of guidelines to regulate content affecting sovereignty and integrity of India and threatens the national security. The rules will regulate internet-based businesses and organizations, OTT platforms, social media companies and digital news outlets, among others. Under the new information technology guidelines for intermediaries and digital media ethics code rules 2021, the center plans to mandate social media companies like Facebook and Twitter to erase contentious content as early as possible, but not later than 36 hours after a government or legal order. The companies will also be mandated to provide information and help with the investigation within 72 hours of request from authorities concerned if any post depicts an individual in any sexual act or conduct, then the firms concerned will be required to disable or remove such content within a day of receiving the complaint. This week, after several rounds of talks, India and China positively appraised the smooth completion of disengagement of frontline troops in the Pangong Lake area and agreed to continue their communication and push for a mutually acceptable resolution of the remaining issues along the line of actual control in the western sector. The exchange took place during the 10th round of China-India Corps Commander level meeting. The meeting was held on the Chinese side of the Moldo-Chushul area. The ministry said that the two sides had a candid and in-depth exchange of views on the other issues along the line of actual control in the western sector. And on the sports front, Indian cricket team made a stunning debut in the newly inaugurated Narendra Modi Stadium and won the pink ball test against England by 10 wickets to take a 2-1 lead in the series. Akshar Patel bagged the Man of the Match award for his outstanding performance. He had scalped a total of 11 wickets and became the first bowler to do so in a day-night test. 81, which is England's second innings total at Narendra Modi Stadium, is the second lowest test total by any team against India. Apart from this, Ashwin became the second fastest bowler to take 400 test wickets. The day-night test match at Motera was the 7th shortest completed test match and the shortest since 1935.
Hope you liked this edition of Your World This Week. We will be back next week with yet another episode of Your World This Week. Have a good day.